The number of FF14 websites and resources is growing by the day, and in this video, I'm sharing some of the most useful links I've been either using or bumping into online. These websites don't endorse me in any way, I just think they're cool and useful. However, there is a little disclaimer here. I can't go on record and guarantee the legitimacy of every single one of the lists, so if you decide to use any of them, do it with a common sense. And if you end up on any website that's asking you for your personal info, passwords, or anything like that, definitely don't go ahead and type those in unless they're verified sources you can trust. My name is Ivona from MomsDen.com, and if we haven't met yet, subbing is a good idea. I make simple guides for classes, dungeons, raids, and collectibles you'll enjoy if you like some easy in-game wins. I currently cover all things Final Fantasy XIV, and I also livestream on this channel quite a lot. If you're looking for a great MMO community, drop by the chat and say hi to us. Eorzea Collection is all about the Final Fantasy XIV glamour, the true endgame. You can go through all the different filters and settings to find glamours for all the genders, levels, jobs with a certain level, most liked glamour sets, and everything in between. If you don't buy items off the Mog Station, you can even exclude uploaded sets that contain any of the paid items. When you're logged in, you also get to save your favorite glamour sets to look at later. Apart from glamours uploaded by others, you can also filter through all the gear sets in the game, see what they look like, and decide if those are what you're looking out to get. Final Fantasy XIV official blog is where you'll find a bunch of news on the current in-game events and access to other FF14 related news. I use this one a lot when I'm checking if a new event is live or going live in-game, and I've been loving it. Salted FF14 is such a terrific website where you get to learn all about your jobs, your spells, rotations, and there's even a gearing guide section for your endgame. You can also find guides for different encounters on various difficulties with both video and text guides, so definitely check out that one if you're looking to raid optimally. Ag Morning is a terrific one if you're playing caster. I personally don't, not yet at least, but if you're a black mage, a red mage, or a summoner, you'll find this site very useful. There's even a streamers page where you can find some cool content creators to watch, and they have plenty of other mini guides to spend time checking out in the meantime. If you're a Twitch streamer, there's a form you can fill out and be featured on their website too. Final Fantasy XIV Collect is one of my newest addictions. In here you can search for your character and track pretty much everything you have once you've logged in with your Discord profile. It tracks your mounts, minions, achievements, hairstyles, orchestrion roles, and a lot more. Not only will you know what and how much you've already got, but there is info on how to obtain every one of the things in the game and how rare they are, so if you're a collector, this resource is a must for you. Apart from the collectibles I mentioned, there's even a Triple Triad card tracker, where you can manually select all the cards you've collected, and the info on how to get the rest is also handily written out, so make sure to check this out if you're a Triple Triad player. Garland Tools is a website mostly for crafters, gatherers, and fishers. It's a big database that you can search for anything in the game. When you search for something in particular, it'll show you which crafter can make it, what you need to craft it, and you can even create a new group for things that you want to craft. You can also check out which things got added in the latest patch if that's something you're interested in. In the Garland Bell section, you can see all the gathering timers. It's awesome to be able to check out the timers of items that you like to collect. If they're green, that means they're up, so you can go ahead and get them. There's also a map showing you where they are and what time they spawn. If something you've been targeting for a long time is up, you can even set up a notification bell to let you know it's there, which is quite convenient. And there's the FF14 Fisher, in which it shows you all sorts of fish, what bait you need for them, and where to catch them. Final Fantasy XIV Gamerscape is a cool website for pretty much any kind of guide you're looking for, like guides for sprouts, different items, quests, duties, logs, and all sorts of activities. The good thing is that this resource is always up to date and super reliable. Another cool website for fellow fishers is the FF14 Angler. In here you'll find tons of info on where to catch fish, what kind of bait you need, and more. There's even a map that does a very good job at showing you where to go. You can look at the photos of where exactly you need to stand and everything else that can be fished in that location. If you're using an ad blocker on your browser though, only the mobile version of the website with some limitations is available, so consider that if it's a deal breaker for you. Final Fantasy XIV Timer is really the simplest of all these websites, but it's really handy as a reminder for when some content pieces are expiring or running out, and it's based on your computer's time zone. You'll find info on all the current events and how long they're gonna be up for, including some of the in-game resets. You can find all this in the game as well, in the timer menu, but if you only need the time estimate without logging into the game, this is a good place to go. Final Fantasy XIV housing website is a gold mine for everyone fortunate enough to, you know, have a house. You can see all the furniture pieces in the pictures just the way they look in the game, which is a lot better than the way furniture items are presented in your inventory or at the vendors without a preview. When you click on a piece of furniture, it'll show you the related furniture as well, so you can make your house look as awesome as possible. Lodestone is the official Square Enix website for Final Fantasy XIV, with an astonishing amount of information, the option for you to log in and see all your character's info, as well as easily access all the other Final Fantasy XIV related websites and services. It's something pretty much everyone knows about, but it simply has to make it to the list because of how diverse and well-maintained it is, regardless of its 2011 kind of look and feel when you stumble upon it. This is another great website with timers for when things are going to be available to gather, and it's super easy to set up notifications for them so you don't miss out on your mats. The console game wiki for Final Fantasy XIV is kind of similar to Gamerscape in its purpose. It's full of guides, in-game information, news and updates, and overall great for teaching you about the game. If you're more of an old-school forum kind of person, Blue Gator FF14 section might be for you. There are a lot of cool topics to discuss. From what I've seen, the place is alive, and it really takes you back to the days of socializing through fan forums. I haven't been too active on there yet, but I might give it a try, as I too had my forum way long ago. It failed spectacularly, unlike this one, but that's a story for another day. If you like forums, but would prefer an official Square Enix one, you can hop into this place. There are a bunch of useful topics, and it has English, Japanese, French, and German sections, which is great as more people can both ask questions and provide feedback within their communities. If you're a roleplay person, there's a home for you too, and that's the Final Fantasy XIV Roleplayers Forum. In here you can find a lot of the stuff I think you'll like, along with the events information and the place to link your own free company within the community. It looks like a lot of fun, and I can see myself poking through it soon. This might be needlessly obvious, but FF14 Reddit is actually a terrific source of information. The non-toxicity of the community allows the hot page to usually be filled with both useful and beautiful things, and searching through Reddit topics in your browser will more often than not give you the quick and easy answers for all your questions. This is not a website per se, but it is a terrific Discord channel with all sorts of information on how to play your jobs, and it's packed with people who know answers to a lot of your questions. If you're more of a Discord person, I highly recommend popping in here. This website is a cool little feature that you can use to create your character's ID card. All you need to do is upload your character's screenshot, select your main job, and provide the Lodestone link of your character's profile. And voila! A cool little image that does absolutely nothing, yet is cool to have. A cool little blog-ish website for everyone who enjoys gardening in FF14 is definitely the way to go. I don't know too much about gardening, but there seems to be a lot of guides and directions on what to do with your seeds, so if you're into this, you'll know a lot more about how gardening works than me, and will make use of this resource accordingly. If you're a completionist with a strong love for checklists, 14 To Do is a great place for you. By linking your Lodestone profile link, you get to see all your completed and unfinished projects in FF14, and you can blur out the spoilers, as your Lodestone knows where you're at in the story. The best feature of this website is by far the daily and weekly checklist of all the things you could be doing before the reset, so if you're any sort of a min-maxer, you are going to love this. 14 Status is where you can see all the statuses of all the worlds and data centers in all the regions. This is useful if you want to create a new character on a particular world and you're camping the spot, or to check what's going on with Aether and chuckle at the absurdity of it right now. Lulu's Tools is actually a group of tools other than a single single one, but if you'd like to calculate your mini cat pods, the odds for your wondrous tales, generate race names, and do all kinds of stuff, you should definitely check out this bundle of joy. There's also the Skywatcher tool that shows the weather in all corners of Eorzea, which is very nice to have. If you're an FF14 raider, or you'd like to be, FF Logs will be of use to you, as that's where you can upload and analyze your logs to help you improve your gameplay and your group's progress. I don't personally do this, and I don't know if I'll ever raid on this level, but it's good to know that it's there. If you're trying to level your squadron team, you're gonna love this little thing, as you get to enter all your mission settings and figure out what to do with your team, if you should even be sending them on some missions, and much more. There's also a full guide on how to do it right on the page, so if this is your thing, knock yourself out. If you'd like to get yourself into Final Fantasy XIV macros, this website is a good place to start, as it has a bunch of different macros for crafting, gathering, combat, and fun. I'm not very much into this just yet, so use these on your own personal responsibilities. They're not mine and I don't endorse them, as I said, but they are there if you're feeling like improving your gameplay in any way you choose. And that is pretty much it when it comes to all the Final Fantasy XIV resources I could think of. Let me know in the comments if you've got any ones you love to use. Huge thanks to the awesome bunch supporting the channel, and if you'd like to do it too and ensure more daily videos, you can become a channel member here or on Patreon. Have fun, and I'll see you in my next video or on live. Bye bye!